So what is the difference between an APU1, an APU2 and an APU3? Hi, I'm Nikki from Yawarra Tiny Computers, and that's a question I've asked Paul more than once, so I figured I wasn't the only one. Firstly, what are these boards? So the APU1, APU2 and APU3 are single board computers from PC Engines. They all have the same 6-inch square footprint, they have gigabit Ethernet, 4GB of RAM, and they're all bootable from USB, SD card, mSATA drive or the SATA drive. So what about the differences? Well, the APU1 was the first board to be released, and the APU2 was released sometime after that. So first, let's take a look at the differences between those two. And there are four main differences between the APU1 and the APU2. Firstly, the APU1 has Realtek NICs, while the APU2 board has Intel NICs. Difference number two, the APU1 board has a dual-core CPU, and the APU2 has a quad-core CPU. Difference number three, is that the APU1 uses 1066 MHz RAM, whereas the APU2 uses 1333 MHz RAM. And difference number four is in the power usage. The APU1 board uses anywhere from 6 to 12 watts, depending on the CPU load, whereas the APU2 uses anywhere from 6 to 10 watts, depending on the CPU load. So basically, the APU2 is an evolution of the APU1. It's faster, it's cooler, and it's more robust. And that's the one that we tend to recommend to people that they use, unless they have a particular reason for using the APU1. So what about the APU2 to the APU3? Well, the APU3 is a relatively new board, and it's a variation of the APU2, and it's optimized for 3G, 4G, and LTE purposes. And there are three main differences between the APU2 and the APU3 because of this. The first difference is that the APU3 is able to take two SIM cards as opposed to the APU2, which can only take one SIM card. In order to do this, the expansion slots on the APU3 are more flexible. Just keep in mind that if you want two SIM cards, you can't have an mSATA drive on the APU3 board. The next difference on the APU3 is that because there are two SIM cards, they've been designed to be swappable under GPIO, which means you can use them for failover. And the final difference between the APU2 and the APU3 is that the power usage for the APU3 board is slightly higher at 6 to 12 watts, depending on CPU load. So, those are the key differences between the APU1, APU2 and APU3 boards. And check out this quick summary that I've put together for you of all the differences that I just outlined. So we currently offer the APU1 and the APU2 products, and we'll probably start offering the APU3 once the board revision moves from B to C, when they tend to be more stable. If you're desperate to get your hands on an APU3 board, just get in touch with us. And if you want to learn more about the APU products in general, I'll put a link in the description of this video. And I will see you next time.